And that is adulterating the cotton. The adulterating the cotton means two separate qualities are being mixed, and because in export it is a grand sale operation, discounted operations, it goes on. But here these mills, I mean the consumer will suffer, our total branding, total effect on our products suffer. So adulteration, in my opinion, is also a great menacing thing for us.
I am a chinar here. I am having factory in Gujarat, Maharashtra and Telangana.
Hello Suresh. I will start with, as it normally happens, the farmer has to take up the mic to speak. And I represent the farmers which we have been training since 2007. I will just start with, Sarve Bhavantu Sukhina, Sarve Santu Niramay, Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu, Ma Kaschit Dukh Bhag Bhavet. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Only together we can survive. The textile chain, the textile supply chain is the longest supply chains of all the commodities. It is a very complicated chain. The more we de-link with the other stakeholders, the more we suffer. It is easier to blame. It is easier to find excuses for our failures. But what if we don't learn out of them? If we don't learn, we fail again. If we fail again, we may not survive. This is the time for survival of the textile industry. The worst scenario which anybody could have imagined has happened. No exports, no domestic buying. Even at a cotton of 2-year low in the domestic market and 5-year low in the international market, no buyers in the market. So I think it is time to come together and to include farmer in the supply chain as a very integral part of the supply chain. The counseling should start from the farmer stage. The first thing that anybody can do is regulate the seeds. There are 2200 varieties of seeds. There is no way that a farmer can know what to sow. All the packets look so similar. So when we sow those seeds, there are multiple types of varieties coming out of those seeds which go to the ginning factory. The adulteration may have started from the field itself. Then the ginning factory does its own part and then it goes to the spinning. So why don't we arrest the adulteration from where it is starting? That is the seed. I would take up the Prime Minister's mission and request Suresh Bhai if he can make a note of it. The Prime Minister has said, zero effect, zero defect. Can we not make at least cotton aligned to that mission? Zero defect is the contamination and zero effect is the environment. Reducing the use of pesticide and water and educating the farmer so that he does not lose the yield there. So there we can have a better control of the quality rather than the ginning factory and the spinning mill.
Proper ginning must be established. There are good chins, honest people. The honest people are whose bales are never opened and they get a premium automatically, and by their only word of mouth their cotton gets sold. There is a ginner like that in Burhanpur. So there are good people available. But now technology.
First is to the chairman. The chairman himself is the
99% no relation to the quality. 99%, unless it is the issue of moisture and trash, which are then added. I mean, it is not the inherent quality of the fiber which will fetch a better price. Only in ELS cotton you can say that the price is defined by the quality, because there it's a very niche market. As a farmer or as a farmer training agency, I can say that it has to be a concentrated effort of a group. An individual farmer can never achieve that. So as a group, what we do, we mark out the farmers in say 100 acres of area, we test the seed cotton, we mail the seed cotton to nearby 6 ginning factories in that area. And do we require this type of cotton? Then collectively we propagate the sale of that cotton. That fetches them a premium of 75 to 150 rupees per quintal, because it is collectively sold and tested in advance. So unless you propagate the quality collectively, it is difficult for an individual. As far as the farmer is concerned, I think the genus can also follow suit.
Out of say normally 18,000 per hectare, they was up to 60,000 and the yield they have achieved up to 1700 cases. So why we are talking so low or so incremental?
To reframe, soil, weather and technology. Only weather is variable, but all the three factors are not addressed upfront right now. We have no indigenous BT seed in India up to now. So if you can come up with a seed suitable to Indian weather, that could be one thing. Soil health monitoring could be the other thing, and percolation of technology at the farm level could help.